Dear friends, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to connect this big 20x4 character LCD display to a Raspberry Pi Pico board. I will also show you how to use it with CircuitPython, and I'll share with you 3 useful projects to help you get started and save you a lot of time. Let's start. This character LCD display is one of my favorite displays of all time. I have used it in many Arduino projects in the past, and I really like it because it is big, inexpensive, it costs around $6, and it is very easy to use, so it is ideal for beginners. This display is a character LCD display, so it cannot display graphics, only characters, but be sure to watch until the end of the video where I'll show you how to make it display some graphics. It has 4 lines, and each line can display 20 characters. The display uses the I2C interface to communicate with a microcontroller, because at the back, it features an I2C backpack with the PCF8574 chip. If your display does not use the same backpack, or if it has no I2C backpack at all, you won't be able to follow this video. The connection to the Raspberry Pi Pico board is very easy. All we have to do is to connect power and 2 more wires. The first pin of the display is the ground pin, so we connect it to a ground pin of the Raspberry Pi Pico board. The second pin of the display is VCC, so we connect it to the 5V output of the board, which is here. The next pin of the board is named SDA, so we connect it to the pin GP0. The fourth pin is named SEL, and we connect it to pin GP1. Easy, wasn't it? Our connections are ready. Let's power up the board to see what happens. As you can see, the display works, and it displays a demo script, a script where it prints some text on the display, then some custom characters, and then it disables the backlight for a second before turning it back on. Cool, our display works. Let's now see the software side of the project. To use the display with CircuitPython, we need to download this library from this GitHub repository. All you have to do is to download this repository and copy the LCD folder it contains in the lib folder of your CircuitPy drive, just like this. Your CircuitPy drive should now look like this. We have a code.py file with the script to run on the board and a lib folder with the LCD library. You can find the links to all the files needed in the video description. Let me now walk you through the code for the first project I showed you. The script first displays some text, followed by some custom characters. First of all, we initialize the LCD object here. We have to enter the I2C address of our display here. The address for my display is this one, but yours may be different. If this one does not work, try this one also. Now let's go to the fun part. The LCD object offers some very useful methods. First, we have the setCursorPosition method, which moves the invisible cursor on the screen. The cursor is just a pointer, which shows where we want to print something. It takes 2 arguments. The first one is the row, and the second one is the column. So, in this line of code, I tell the script to move the cursor to the first line of the screen, which has an index of 0, and then move it to the fourth column. Next, we can print something on the screen with the method print. The method just prints a string on the screen, starting from the position of the cursor. Another very useful method is the clear method, which just clears the screen. Cool! Now, as I said earlier, the display can only display characters and not graphics. But it has a very cool feature. It allows us to create our own custom characters and display them on the screen. It can save up to 8 custom characters in its memory. Using that feature, we can do some very cool things. But first, let me show you how to create your own custom characters. Each custom character is just a tuple, a read-only list in Python, of some values. For example, here, I declare the 4 tuples needed for the custom characters I created. A phone icon, a heart icon, a speaker, and a smile. Let's create another one. How do we create one? It is very easy. I developed a very simple online tool to do just that. All you have to do is to visit this URL, design your own character using this tool, and when ready, the tool will produce the code for it automatically, either as binary values or hex values. I prefer using hex because it is shorter. So I create a new bell icon, I choose the hex button, and then I press the copy code button. Now, back to our code. Let's paste the new custom character here and name it bell, for example. Okay, now we have the values we need. Now we need to store them inside the display. As we said, the display can store up to 8 characters. I'm only using 4 so far, and I want to add another one. So let's store the new custom character to the display memory. We need to use the createChar method of the LCD object. LCD.createChar, parentheses, 4, that's the position in the display memory. It starts counting from 0, that's why we enter 4 for the 5th item. And then the variable that holds the data we want to store, comma, bell. That's it, the character is now saved. If we want to print it, all we have to do is to move the cursor where we want the character to be displayed. For example, let's move it to the 3rd row and the 9th column. And then all we have to do is to call the write method of the LCD object, lcd.write, and we pass the location in the display memory of the character we want to display. We want to display the bell character that we saved in position 4. So we enter 4 here. Let's run the code. The new icon appears. How cool is that? By the way, if what I just shared with you and the online tool I created is really useful, then I would love it if you will give this video a like so more people can learn about this easy procedure. Now, using this technique, we can create countless icons. And if we combine more characters together, we can achieve impressive things. Check out this script, which displays a dinosaur. I combined 8 custom characters to create a dinosaur graphic. We can easily turn this into a game if we wish. So, even though this is a character display, with some imagination we can do some pretty cool things. For example, I created another thermometer project that uses the embedded temperature sensor of the Raspberry Pi Pico board. I also created some custom characters and combined them to create a bigger font. As you can see, with tricks like this we can make impressive projects. I really like this display because it is so easy to work with and so fun. Additionally, programming in CircuitPython speeds up and simplifies development even more. If you haven't used CircuitPython yet, I strongly recommend that you do so. You will like it. Don't worry if you don't know how to code in Python. I have got a thorough free course ready on my second channel. In just a few hours, it will teach you the fundamentals. Check it out right away. You'll benefit much. I appreciate you watching and I'll see you again soon.